Buddy, I know that reviewing all those movies is a lot of work.
Tell me about it.
And therefore, I want to play a little game today. Mix things up, have some fun.
I love games.
Perfect. This is called the memory game. I say the name of a famous person. Then you will say the name I said and say an additional name of your choice. Then it's my turn again and so on and so forth. Understood?
Yeah, sounds easy.
Okay, I'll start. Rabindranath.
Rabindranath, Karl Marx.
Rabindranath, Karl Marx, Jimmy Cage.
Rabindranath, Karl Marx, Jimmy Cage, Buddymeister.
Out.
What?
Out. Only famous people count. Servus Freunde, my name is Jimmy Cage.
And I'm Dennis, the Buddymeister.
And this year marks the 100th birthday of one of the greatest filmmakers of all time, Satyajit Ray. And therefore we decided not just to review one film on his actual birthday in May, but to talk about several of his wonderful works throughout the entire year.
We have already reviewed quite a few of his films prior to the one today, and we will link all previous videos in the description below.
We actually would have loved to go through his entire filmography, but unfortunately some of his films are only available in really bad quality. We tried to watch even those, but the version simply couldn't do his films justice. So we will skip a few and hope for better versions in the future.
But let's talk about today's film, which is Aranyer Din Ratri, or Days and Nights in the Forest, from 1970. An adventure drama written and directed by Satyajit Ray, it's loosely based on a novel by Sunil Ganguly.
This adventure takes place in Palamau, a forest area of Bihar, which is a place that has a special significance for Bengali people. To quote what Andrew Robinson has written in his Satyajit Ray biography, as the place of first encounter of tribal India by a modern Bengali in Bengali literature, Palamau made a deep impression on the Bengali imagination, something like the reputation of the Wild West in North America.
The mythic character of Palamau is established at the very beginning of the movie, prior to the opening credits, when our four protagonists are reading about it in an old book of the same name by author Sanjeev Chatterjee, who was sort of a forest officer there.
The four protagonists are Asim, Sanjay, Shekhar and Hardy, seemingly wealthy and in the prime of their lives. That's actually a big difference between the film and the novel, because in the novel the four are more like vagabonds who travel by train and not by car like they do in the movie.
They are obviously well-heeled in the film, even bragging and arrogant, like they can solve any problem in the world with the right amount of money. But it quickly becomes clear that there's more to these guys and that they are full of longing and in search of something meaningful in a way.
Apparently the movie, as opposed to the novel, was somewhat easier to identify with, or rather the characters in it, by a Western audience. These middle-class young guys who have everything one could wish for, but who are still feeling that something is missing, and who are seeking a getaway, even if just for a brief time, somewhere outside, away from the big city and the daily routine. And honestly, I can relate a lot to that myself.
Exactly, yes. And these characters are the driving forces in this movie. There's very little plot in a conventional sense. The characters and the universal themes are what keeps Days and Nights in the Forest going. I think that's also what makes this movie an adventure.
What I like most is how casually the story, or rather the events, are unfolding, and how delicately small and big things about the characters and their relationships are revealed and further developed.
Yes, step by step and very subtle. It's also nice how we have one story at the beginning, the story of these four guys, but then it splits up into four stories, because every one of them goes on his own adventure. But it doesn't stay like that. These two narrative styles are alternating. Sometimes the four are together, sometimes they're not, and that keeps everything interesting.
And of course, through that, we witness how they change, how they learn something, how they grow. The setting is quite typical for Satyajit Ray, because we again have this confrontation of city and country. As you already said, at the beginning they are pretty condescending and arrogant, but in the end, sincerity gains the upper hand.
They are confronted with something they do not know, and their brashness doesn't help. Instead, their beings are more or less exposed, largely by the people they meet. First and foremost by Aparna, played by Shamila Tagore, and Jaya, played by Kaveri Bose.
They get into situations that are demanding and that spawn feelings that they did not expect, like when Jaya tries to seduce Sanjay and breaks out in tears. Or of course when they wash themselves by the well and are caught off guard by the two women. The darkest turn takes the adventure of Hardy, who, after sleeping with a Santal girl, a tribal inhabitant of the region, gets clobbered by a servant who takes revenge on him for being maltreated earlier. He almost dies.
Yes, almost, but he learned his lesson, hopefully. I guess the only character that doesn't develop as much as the others is Shekhar, who's kind of the comic relief in all of this. It's not like he's making jokes all the time, but he throws in the most comical comments.
I would say so too. However, as this is a character-driven film, it's of course also an actor's film, and everybody gives a great performance. Especially Soumitra Chatterjee and Subhendu Chatterjee, besides Shamila Tagore and Kabiri Bose, which we mentioned earlier.
Yes, and naturally, Days and Nights in the Forest looks wonderful. The cinematography was done by Soumendu Roy and not Subrata Mitra, who shot most of Rai's films. But Soumendu Roy actually worked as an assistant to Subrata. He handled the trolley and the lighting.
The cinematography is really good. The version we watched didn't have the best quality, but it's still pretty gorgeous. With Days and Nights in the Forest, it's like with most of Rai's films. Every word and gesture, every movement is conceivable and authentic. And Rai again also composed the music for the movie.
Yeah, it's not that prominent all the time, but there are some wonderful scenes where it underlines the gravity of the situation, like the one with Jaya and Sanjay.
And like with Rai's other films, everything seems so effortless. In the 2-hour runtime, we become part of their little vacation, and somehow we get the feeling to be part of something deeply human.
Absolutely. There are even some quite funny or quirky moments to be found here. The banter between those guys, how they get completely wasted at night, or how they just lay around in their apartment. Again, it also feels very relatable.
And then there's also this long picnic scene that we referenced in our opening skit. They play this game for quite some time, and you wonder how long Rai is able to pull this off without it getting annoying.
True, but it doesn't. There's a certain energy there, and there's also a lot that's happening between the lines, so to say. How each one is playing the game and reacting a little bit differently.
It's a very memorable scene for sure. And at the end, their trip is over. They get back in the car and drive home. They definitely learned something and they've definitely grown, but they also seem pretty happy to get back to the city, especially Shekhar and Hari, who may or may not be that much wiser.
True, but I think each one of them takes something home.
So, what would we say in German about Days and Nights in the Forest?
Days and Nights in the Forest ist ein Film voller Leben, der eben jenes so wundervoll und organisch durch seine tollen, sehnsüchtigen Charaktere widerspiegelt. Ein befreiender Kurztrip, bei dem jeder etwas anderes mitnehmen kann.
I give Days and Nights in the Forest 8 out of 10. It's more like 8.1, but I don't do that.
For me, it's also 8 out of 10. It's more like 8.2, but I don't do that either. Did you know that there's a sequel to this movie that was released in 2003? So, 33 years later, almost all of the actors and actresses took part. It's called Abar Aranye, In the Forest Again.
Sounds like a terrible comedy. Let's never watch that.
Never.
Alright, what are your thoughts about Days and Nights in the Forest? Please leave a comment. And you can hit me up on Twitter, Instagram, Letterboxd and also on Patreon, simply at The Jimmy Cage.
And you can hit me up on Twitter at The Buddymeister.
You can also become a member of the channel and get exclusive rewards. And if you enjoyed this episode, please give us a thumbs up, share, subscribe, whatever you like. And make sure you hit that bell for All We Have to Tell.